Jack Hubbard, the meteorologist for the Trinity Test, had a very difficult job. When would the thunderstorms, high winds, dust devils, and other obstacles clear? Jim Eckles explains why predicting the weather was so vital.
You know, the bomb was initially scheduled for July 4th. They wanted to make it the ultimate firecracker, the 4th of July firecracker. And then uncertainties and weather issues started interfering with that schedule and pushing it to the right further and further. So the 16th was a day that the weather guys said looks like a good day based on the typical summer thunderstorms rolling through at that time of year. So everybody associated with the project that was familiar with New Mexico knew that thunderstorms were going to be an issue at that time of year. And boy, they're pretty unpredictable. It really would have been tough back in those days. They didn't have the satellite imagery and all that. I mean, it's all very unpredictable. And so it would have been quite a nightmare, a lot of pressure on the weather guy. There are a number of things to take into consideration if you've got storms. One is wind, high winds. You know, thunderstorms, it can be calm 1 minute and the next minute the wind's blowing 50 miles an hour. And so if you've got a storm like that blowing during the test, you're going to have radiation fallout going God knows where, because storms have got swirling winds and stuff. So that would have been very unpredictable. It's not a test just to see if it works. That's big part of it, but you also want to try to get as much information as you can to see how it works, to collect as much data as you can, to see how that implosion process is working and how sweet it's going to be as far as the design and stuff. And to be able to collect that data, you need pretty good weather. You need those cameras to be able to see things 5.5 miles away and stuff. And you can't do that in a thunderstorm. Of course, then there's the whole issue of lightning while the bomb's sitting on the tower, which is another reason driving the decision not to wait a day till the next morning, but to go at 5:30 instead of 4. There's some pressure to get this test done because you've got an armed bomb on top of a steel tower and lightning's flashing around. It might set off the bomb, probably not, but it might damage the bomb. And then you're back to square one. You've got to start all over. So a lot of pressure to go ahead and get the test done at 5:30.